Hello student, today I will explain second chapter of first life, Nelson Mandela, a long walk to freedom. As you all know that the famous quote of Nelson Mandela, education is the weapon to change the world. And he literally proved that anything can be possible. First of all, I will introduce about the author and about the chapter and then line by line explanation. So let's start introduction about the author. Nelson Mandela was a South African political leader, politician, revolutionary and a philanthropist who played a key role in ending the apartheid regime of the 20th century. He served as the country's first black president from 1994 to 1999 and is considered one of the most significant figures of the 19th century. He was the winner of the 1993 Nobel Peace Prize for his role in bringing the apartheid regime to a peaceful end and laying the foundation for a truly democratic South Africa. Now introduction about the chapter. Long Walk to Freedom is the autobiography of former South African President Nelson Mandela. Exploring theme of racial equality, political protest and the ability of the human spirit to overcome great hardship, Long Walk to Freedom is considered one of the most acclaimed and important autobiographies of the late 19th century. Now, summary of the chapter. Nelson Mandela was born on July 18, 1918. He was first South African president to be elected in a fully representative democratic election. He swore in as first black president of South Africa on 10th May 1994. In life, every man has twin obligation to his family, to his parents, to his wife and children, and he has an obligation to his people, his community and his country. In a civil and human society, each man is able to fulfill those obligations according to his own inclination and abilities. But in a country like South Africa, it was almost impossible for a man of my birth and color to fulfill both to those obligations. In South Africa, a man of color who attempted to live as a human being was punished and isolated. In South Africa, a man who tried to fulfill his duty to his people was inevitably ripped from his family and his home and was forced to live a life apart. He said, as quoted, "I did not in the beginning choose to place my people. I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligation." He said, as quoted, "I did not in the beginning choose to place my people. I found that I was prevented from fulfilling my obligation as a son, a brother, a father and a husband. It was only when I began to learn that my boyhood freedom was an illusion. When I discovered as a young man that my freedom had already been taken from me, that I began to hunger for it. As a first, a student, I wanted freedom only for myself. The transitory freedom of being able to stay out at night, read what I pleased, and go where I choose. I was not unmindful of the fact that not so many years before they would not have isolated but arrested me. Finally, a chevron of Impala jail left a small trial of the black, red, green, blue and gold of the new South Africa flag. It was this desire for the freedom of my people to live their lives with dignity and self-respect that animated my life, that transformed a frightened young man into a bold one, that drove a law-abiding attorney to become a criminal, that turned a family loving husband into a man without a home, that forged a life loving man to live like a monk. I'm no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man. I'm no more virtuous or self-sacrificing than the next man. But I found that I could not even enjoy the poor and limited freedom I was allowed when I knew my people were not free. Freedom is individual. The chain on any one of my people were the chains on all of them. The chain and all of my people were the chain on me. I knew that the oppressor must be liberated just as surely as the oppressed. A man who takes away another man's freedom is a prison of hatred. He is locked behind the bar of the prejudices and narrow-mindedness. I'm not truly free if I'm taking away someone else's freedom just as surely as I am not free when my freedom is taken from me. The oppressed and the oppressor alike are robbed of their humanity. So student, it was the explanation of the chapter Nelson Mandela. If you have any problem related to this chapter, you can write it in the comment box. Thank you.